In this video, I will show you how to import and export patches from your Katana Bass using the Boss Tone Studio. So I'm going to assume that you have already downloaded the Boss Tone Studio for Katana Bass software on your computer, and that you have updated the firmware on your Katana Bass and have it connected to the computer. If you have problems with updating the firmware, you can find another video that I made earlier about that will help you update the firmware on that Katana Bass. You'll find that on my YouTube channel, I'm sure, if you need it. So when you open up the Boss Tone Studio for Katana Bass, you will see that you have all of your patches on the left side. And this is kind of like a live feed of your bass amp. So these patches that you see here are the patches that you actually have on your bass amp right now. If you go to the Librarian, you will find all of your live sets that you have created. So a live set, or that you've downloaded for that matter, a live set is like a playlist of all of your patches. So I've created a live set called Andreas Oxholm Katana Bass Patches, which you can download from my website. I made 6 patches that you can download, and you can upload them to your Katana Bass and have the same sounds as I have. And I'm using that as my default sounds and default patches on my bass amp. So if you go to the right side, you have an arrow pointing up, which is the export button. And then you have an arrow pointing down, which is the import or download button. So if I want to export either a live set, so you categorize all of your patches as live sets. And if you have just one patch, then you just create a live patch with one. You create a live set with one patch, just like this Blues P bass here. It's only one patch. And if I want to export this to as a file, then I'll click file there. We could export it there. But at the same time, if I would like to export this live set to my Katana Bass, then I could just click Katana Bass there. Anyways, so now I've just exported the file called Blues P Bass. You can see I've already done the Katana Bass patches. So these are all .tsl files, and those files are the ones that you have patches. So if you want to send your patches to someone, or you want to just upload them to the to your drive and then import it on another Katana Bass, for example, then you use the TSL files. So when you are here at the Librarian, I could drag and drop this patch here, for example, over to Bank A Channel 2. Let's see, there we go. Then when this is done exporting, my Channel 2 on my Bank A will now be Blues P Bass. And if I would like to change this and make my bass back to the default, then I will go to export button and I will select the full patch that I've made here with all the 6 6 patches. And then I click Katana Bass. So when this is done, then my Katana Bass will be back to the default and everything's going to be normal again. So if you don't already know this, the Katana Bass has 2 banks. So you have the panel setting, which is like the live, the settings that it has not any saved function. Then you have 3 patches on the bank A, and then you have 3 patches on bank B. If you hold down the panel setting, if you hold down the panel button for over a second or something, then you will be able to access bank B. So now you can see the live feed on the left side here. My bass is back to my default. If you were to import either directly from your Katana Bass and into the Boss Tone Studio, you click this one. Or if you want to import just the TSL file that you've downloaded from a friend or that you've downloaded from your computer, then you can just click the file and it will be created as a live set here in the Librarian, and then you can do what you want there. Or repeat the section with the export file. All right? It's nice, it's fast, it's simple. And I know there are a lot of videos on this for Katana guitar, and which will probably be enough information for you to do it on your Katana Bass. But if you are a little bit like me, I always prefer watching videos that are specific to my product in case there are some difference in the products in the later date. All right, I hope this helped. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.